Now allow your breathing to come naturally to its own rhythm. Allow the warmth of your breath to go to any area of your body that is tense or sore. And allow the breath to relieve the tension or soreness that is there. Imagine your breath gathering up all of the tension and soreness in your bodies and breathing it out so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. Connect with a personal intention for this practice. That intention could be physical, mental, or spiritual, and it could be for you or for someone you love. Seal that intention with one deep inhale and one deep exhale. Good job. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Exhale, knees to the left, arms to the right. Look over that right shoulder and breathe. Breathing into those right obliques, opening them up, releasing toxins from New Year's Eve or whenever. Again, breathing in and out. Inhale those knees and arms back to center. Exhale, knees to the right, arms to the left. Look over that left shoulder and breathe. Again, we're breathing into those left obliques this time, releasing toxins, and we're massaging our internal organs as we do so. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Wrap your arms around your knees. Grab opposite elbows. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. And then grab those insteps. Drag your knees down towards your shoulder blades. Push up with your feet. Pull down with your hands and happy baby. Maybe rock back and forth, dragging those shoulders back and down as much as possible. Massaging your lower backs and your kidneys once again. Good job. Inhale those knees back to center. Exhale, extend your legs above you, flex your feet. Draw your arms up overhead. And then allow your feet to fall down to a 45 degree angle. Inhale first. Exhale as you draw those knees in. Inhale out. Exhale, draw them in. Inhale out. Exhale, draw them in. Either two more or seven more, depending on where you are. Inhale out. Exhale, draw them in. Inhale out. Exhale in. Again, you can stop here, put your arms around your knees, or follow us. Inhale out. Exhale in. Inhale out. Exhale. In, inhale out, exhale in, two more, inhale out, follow the sun, exhale in,
which way the wind
goes, inhale back,
when
Exhale forward. Good job. Wrap your arms around your knees. Rock back and forth. Place your feet as wide as the mat. Arms are out east and west. Inhale first. Exhale, allow those knees to fall all the way to the left as far as possible. Again, opening up those hips. In windshield wipers. Inhale back to center. Exhale down to the right as far as you can. Open up those hips. One more time. Inhale to center. Exhale down to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale down to the right. Inhale those knees back to center. Exhale, extend your legs below you. Roll over onto the left side, left elbow, left palm of your hand down. Inhale that right knee in, grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you, infinity pose. Drag that right shoulder back and down. Breathing in and out three times.
Tomorrow's a new day for everyone.
And smile. It's Monday and we're in a new year now. Everything's going to get better. Everything's going to be easier. We now have a vaccine. We're all going to be able to see each other. Meet in person. Just take a few months.
When you feel this crazy society.
Inhale, that right knee in. Exhale, extend. Roll over onto the right side, right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale that left knee in, grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you again. Dragging that left shoulder back and down. Breathing in and out in infinity pose. Three deep breaths here. Inhale, that left knee in. Exhale, extend below you. Place your hands behind your thighs. Spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again. Allowing each vertebrae to come back into alignment. Let's do three or four of these. And come up to the tops of our mats in Sukhasana, simple seated pose. Sitting up straight, shoulders back and down, placing our hands on our knees. Inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale down onto that right elbow. Look up towards the ceiling, drag that left shoulder back and down. Breathing in and out, opening up those left obliques. Again, and smile. We're in 2021. Yay! Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Inhale that right arm all the way up. Exhale down to the left. Onto that left elbow. Look up towards the ceiling. Drag that right shoulder back and down. Keep your right hip down. Open up those right obliques as much as you can. Breathing in and out. Good job and smile. Yay. Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Inhale as you extend your legs in front of you. I'm going to turn this down just a little. Flex those feet, sit up straight, 90 degree angle. Inhale, both arms up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips. Reach, 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 reach as you do. Place your hands on either side of your calves. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale down in Dandasana, staff pose, as far as you can, and then just melt. Breathing in and out. Again, as you breathe in, find where there's resistance in the body. As you breathe out, breathe that resistance out. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you bend that left knee. Looking into half dandasana. Placing your left heel at your hip bone. Inhale, both arms all the way up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips. Reach, 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 reach. And then just melt in half dandasana. Good job, everyone. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Exhale as you draw that knee to center. Now, first of all, we're going to go ahead and wrap our left arm. So we place our left shoulder exactly side by side with our left knee. Wrap that arm around your leg. Wrap your right arm around as well. If you have a strap, use your strap. Place it in your right hand. And then sit up. Open up as much as you can, breathing in and out. Good job, everyone. Exhale, from forward. Then cross that left foot over your right knee. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale as you bend your elbow. Open up to the back of the room. Twisting, keeping that right foot flexed. Releasing toxins. Breathing in and out. Good job, everyone. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you extend that left leg. Shake it out. Inhale first. Exhale as you bend that right knee. Dragging that right heel into your sit bone. Flex that left foot. Inhale, both arms all the way up. Exhale, fold forward. Reach, 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 reach. And then just melt shin to shin as much as you can. In half dandasana, breathing in and out. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you fold that right knee in. Place your right shoulder so that it is parallel with that right knee. Reach back with your right hand. Reach back with your left. Again, you can use a strap here if you want to. Inhale as you sit up. And breathe. Keep that left foot flexed, opening up that whole left side of your body. Breathing in and out. Exhale forward. Release. And then cross that right foot over your left knee. Inhale that left arm up. Bend your elbow. Place it on the outside of your right knee. And open up to the back of the room. Twisting, releasing toxins. Keeping that left foot flexed. And breathe. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you release that foot. Shake it out. Good job. Cross your legs in Sukhasana. Place your fingertips on the mat. Inhale that right arm up and over. Find that left ear. And exhale as you drag your head over to the right as much as possible. Breathing in and out. Keep those left fingertips on the mat. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale down. Inhale that left arm up and over. Find that right ear and exhale over to to the left. Those right fingertips down. And breathe. Inhale that left arm up. Exhale down. Good job. Place your hands on your shoulders. Baby bird, 10 times forward, 10 times back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job. And then from here, place your hands on the mat and roll up into table. In table, our shoulders are above our wrists. Our hips are above our knees. And if we look between our legs, we shouldn't see our feet. Inhale. Stick out, right? Those spines down. Look up towards the ceiling as much as you can. To cat, exaggerate the motions as you transition, bending those elbows, drag your spines up, gaze at your navel, inhale, to cow, open up those spines, exhale, to cat, one more time, inhale, to cow, and exhale. Good job. Come back to a flat back. Inhale that right arm all the way up. Exhale, cross under. Coming down onto that right shoulder. Keep your hips square to the front of the room. Square and thread the needle. If you'd like to, inhale that left arm up. Bend your elbow. Find that right hip crease. And breathe. Opening our hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Breathing in and out. And smile. It's 2021. Inhale that left arm up. Exhale down. Inhale that right arm all the way up. And exhale down. Good job. This time, inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale, thread it under, coming down onto that left shoulder. Keep your hips square to the front of the room. Inhale that right arm up. Bend your elbow. Find that left hip crease and breathe. Opening your hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale down. Inhale that left arm all the way up. And exhale down. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and curl our toes under, sit back on our heels, making infinity symbols with our wrists, clasping our hands. Opening up our toes, opening up our wrists as well. Breathing in and out. Again, we're here for 1 minute. Just settle in. Okay, we're getting there. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rock forward on your elbows. Slap on your toes. Place your toes together, knees as wide as the mat. Inhale first. Exhale, draw your hips down towards your heels. Draw your chest down towards your mat. Draw all four corners of your torso down towards the mat. In Balasana with Baddha Konasana knees. Again, you can keep your knees under your torso if you'd like to. Breathing in and out. Maybe place your third eye on the mat and massage it, rocking back and forth. And then slowly inhale as you come back up to table. Good job. Then from here, if you have a shirt to tuck in, go ahead and tuck it in. Actually, I don't need to tuck this one in. Curl your toes under, lift your hips, drag your chest back towards your thighs. Plant those palms into the mat. Plant that area between your index finger and thumb into the mat as well. We're in our first Ardha Mukha Shavasana. Downward facing dog. Maybe walking the dog. Lifting first one heel and then the other. Dragging the other one down towards the mat. Breathing in and out. Good job, everyone. Let's go ahead and inhale that right leg all the way up behind us. Three-legged dog split. Exhale, swing it through to a lunge. Now you can place that left knee down, left top of foot down, or you can stay with us, inhaling up to crescent A or crescent B. So either have that left knee up or down, wherever you are is perfect. Look up towards your third eye, pinky fingers in. Shoulders are back and down. Exhale to the right. Opening east and west. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. One more time. Inhale to center. Exhale to the right. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale down. Now again, you can either place that left knee down or follow me. Inhale that left arm up, windmill. Exhale down. Right arm up. Exhale down. One more time. Inhale up, left. Exhale down. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale down, good job. And then from here, inhale that right leg through. Exhale down. Now you can either go through your vinyasa, rotate forward into plank. Draw those elbows in. Inhale first. Exhale, chaturanga down. Inhale up. Into Sphinx pose. Place your elbows on the mat. Palms of your hands are down. Exhale as you bend that left knee. Look back at your left foot. Inhale forward. Exhale, look back at your right foot. Inhale forward. Exhale, back at your left foot. Inhale forward. Exhale, back at your right foot. Good job. Inhale forward. Place your hands at shoulder height. Curl your toes under. Exhale all the way back to down dog. Walk the dog. Good job. Inhale through your nose this side out. Inhale. One more time, inhale. Inhale that left leg all the way up behind you, three-legged dog split. Exhale, swing it forward to a lunge. Again, you can place that right knee down, right top of foot down, or inhale up with us to crescent. So we're in crescent A or crescent B. Again, hips are squared to the front of the room. Shoulders back and down, looking up at our third eye. Exhale to the left. Opening east and west. Inhale forward. Exhale to the right. Inhale forward. Exhale to the left. Inhale forward. Exhale to the right. Inhale forward. And exhale down. Again, you can place that right knee down, right top of foot down if you like. Or inhale that right arm up. Exhale down, windmill. Left arm up. Exhale down. Right arm up. Exhale down. Left arm up. Exhale down. Inhale that left leg through and down. Rotate forward this time. Draw those elbows in. Inhale first. Exhale, chaturanga down. Inhale up to up dog or cobra. Curl those toes under. Exhale back to down dog. Good job. Inhale through your nose to side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. Come up on your tippy toes. Bend your knees and either step or jump up. Inhale, halfway up. To Ardha Tadasana. Draw your shoulders back and down. Flatten out your backs. Look towards the front of the room. Exhale, down to Uttanasana. Standing forward fold. We're working towards getting the palms of our hands onto the mat. Inhale all the way up. Swan head backwards. Hands come together. Slight back bend. And hands come to Anjali Mudra. Bowing our heads in honor of our practices. Good job. Now let's do some balance.
So I'm going to move the camera just a little bit so you can see me.
There you go. Standing in Tadasana at the tops of our mats. Drawing all four corners of our feet into the mat. Lift your toes. Calf muscles moving inward. Thighs are moving inward. Pelvis down the back, abdomen is in. Our shoulders are back and down. The crowns of our heads are moving towards the heavens. Hands are open to receive. Find a drishti or a focal point. Be that mountain, Tadasana. Hands come to Anjali Mudra. Come up on those right tippy toes. Draw your right heel to your left ankle, to your left calf, or all the way up to your left thigh. In Vrikshasana, tree pose. Throw those branches overhead into Talasana, palm tree. Draw your hands together up above in Utthita and down. Good job. Draw that knee to a marching position. Flex your foot. Draw those arms overhead. We're in stork now. Into the Utthita, draw those hands together overhead. And exhale down. And then you can follow me or not. We're going to move into Vrikshasana 3, Warrior Pose 3. So exhale, as you draw that leg through, open up your arms. I can't, unfortunately, extend that leg behind me because I don't have enough room. But we have airplane arms. Inhale all the way back up again into a marching position. Hands are at Anjali Mudra. Exhale as you draw that leg behind you. So your foot is at a 45 degree angle. We're moving into pyramid. Good job. Inhale as you draw those arms behind you. Draw your shoulders back and down. We're in Venus Mudra. Exhale, as you fold forward, hinge at the hips. Reach, 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 reach with the tops of your heads. All the way down, shin to shin. Allow those wrists to fall towards the center of the room with gravity, if this is in your practice. And then draw those hands back towards your waist. Release, place your hands on either side of your foot. Inhale, halfway up. Look towards the front of the room. Flat back. Exhale, down. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, down. Inhale all the way up. Hands come together. Exhale as you bring those hands down to Anjali Mudra once again. Inhale that right knee through. Flex your foot. Find that drishti. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Exhale down. Good job. Shake it out. We'll do the other side now. Good job, everyone. Growing all four corners of our feet into the earth. Again, we're standing in Tadasana, mountain pose. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on those left tippy toes. Draw your left heel to your right ankle, to your right calf, or all the way up to your right thigh. Watching that drishti, don't watch me. Draw those arms overhead into Talasana or a palm tree. Draw your hands together, Utthita, and down. Good job. Draw that knee into a marching position. Flex your foot. Inhale those arms up overhead. Into stork. Utthita. And down. Then dive in to Virabhadrasana 3 with airplane arms. Again, extend that leg behind you if you have enough room. Inhale back up to a marching position. Exhale as you draw that foot back at a 45 degree angle. Inhale as you take Venus Mudra behind you, shoulders back and down. Exhale as you hinge at the hips, humbly bowing yourselves over that right leg as far as you can, shin to shin. Allow those fists to come towards the center of the room with gravity. If this is in your practice, open up those shoulders. Draw those hands back towards your waist. And then release in pyramid. Inhale, halfway up. Shoulders back and down. Flatten out your back. Exhale, down. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale down. Inhale all the way up. Swan that backwards. Hands come together. Exhale, Anjali Mudra. Inhale as you step through. Drawing that right or left knee forward. Sorry. Flex your foot. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Exhale down. Shake it out. Good job, everyone. Standing at the tops of our mats, take a giant step back with that left foot. Toes in, heels out. Draw your hands back to Venus Mudra once again. Inhale first. Exhale. Hinge at the hips. Fold forward. Reach with the top of your head as far as you can as you're moving downward. Allow those wrists to fall towards the center of the room with gravity. Draw them back towards your waist. Place heels out. Exhale as you walk those hands through, drawing the crowns of your heads down towards the mat. Breathing in and out. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale first, placing that left hand a little bit further out. Inhale that right arm all the way up. Exhale, cross under, grabbing your thigh, your calf, or your ankle. Inhale that left arm up. If this is in your practice, bend your elbow, find that right hip crease, and breathe in Prasarita Paddottanasana. Drawing the crown of your head down towards the mat as much as possible. Inhale that left arm up. Exhale down. Inhale that right arm all the way up. And exhale down. Good job. This time, inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale, cross under. Grabbing your thigh, your calf, or your ankle. You can stay here, or inhale that right arm up. Exhale, bend your elbow. Find that left hip crease and breathe. Drawing the crowns of your heads down towards the mat. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale down. Inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale down. Good job. And then from here, inhale first. Exhale as you bend that left knee. Extend your right leg. Flex your right foot. Your heel is on the mat. We're in flying monkey. Now you can stay here, sitting on your heel. Or you can draw those hands to Anjali Mudra. Find a drishti out in front of you. All the way up above you in flying monkey. Exhale as you draw those hands down. Use the strength of your legs to come up to the top of the mat in flying monkey on the right side. And again, this time, the heel of your left foot is on the mat. Maybe inhale those arms up overhead if this is in your practice. Good job. Release. And then twist towards the front of the room. Walk that foot over to the left side of the mat. Place your right knee down. Left knee down. Top of left foot down. We're moving in to resting pigeon. You can either be here or on your backs, wherever you like is fine. Inhale as you walk those hands back. You can walk them forward or you can draw them behind you in Venus Mudra. Shoulders back and down. Inhale first. Exhale, humbly bow yourself. Maybe place that left cheek on the mat. If this is in your practice, in a full body twist. Again, if you're moving down on your backs, do so now, bending that right knee, placing your right ankle just below your left knee. Maybe clasping your hands around that left thigh and drawing that left thigh in to open up that right hip as much as possible, releasing any unwanted emotions that you may be storing there. That people can't see me. I'm going to quickly adjust my camera and stay where you are.
There we go.
Slowly inhale as you walk those hands back again. Come up on that right hip. Swing that left leg all the way around. Left foot is parallel to the right thigh. Bring that right foot in and that right elbow in. Inhale that left arm up and around. Find your right hip crease Maybe take a bind if this is in your practice. In the Marianrasana twist. Breathing as you do, releasing toxins, massaging our internal organs. Good job. Slowly release. Extend your legs. Shake it out. Good job. Fix my mat. We'll do the other side, coming up to the tops of our mats in Malasana, yogi squat. Placing the backs of our biceps just below our knees. All four corners of our feet are in the mat. Although if this is too difficult, you can put a bolster under your heels. Sitting up straight, maybe moving into Bakasana. Placing your hands on the mat in front of you. Rocking back and forth until you find that sweet spot. Lifting your toes behind you, looking straight out in front of you in Bakasana or Crow Pose. You can stay here if you'd like to, building your arm strength, bone density, core strength, or come back to Malasana. Inhale from your root chakras all the way up through your crown chakra. And exhale down again. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Good job. Place your hands on the mat. Inhale halfway up to Ardha. Take a giant step back with that right foot. Walk your left foot all the way across. If you're moving down on your backs, do so now. Left knee down, right top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Maybe take Venus Mudra, shoulders back and down. Exhale, fold forward, humbly bowing yourselves. Place your right cheek on the mat. And humbly bowing, resting pigeon. Again, if you're on your backs, cross that left knee over, placing your left ankle just below your right knee. Clasp your hands around your right thigh, draw it in, opening up that left hip, releasing any unwanted emotion you may be storing there. Again, and breathe. This is one of the most healing positions in yoga. It's so important to open those hips. Inhale as you walk your hands back again. Come off on that left hip. Swing your right leg all the way around. Right foot is parallel to your left thigh. Bring that left foot in and that left elbow in. Inhale that right arm up and around. Find that left hip crease. Maybe take a bind if this is in your practice. And breathe in the Marianrasana twist. Releasing toxins, massaging our internal organs. Good job, everyone. Inhale back to center. Uncross your legs and shake them out. Make sure that you have your block handy. Place your heels out in front of you. Place your hands at shoulder height. Inhale as you push up into upward facing plank. Breathing in and out. Exhale down. Jump. Bend your knees as you inhale. Arms are up either side of your knees. Exhale inch by inch. Vertebrae by vertebrae down to the mat. And when you get there, draw those knees in for a much deserved hug. Good job. Rock back and forth. Place your heels just below your sit bones. Yes. Inhale as you push up. Place that block underneath your sacrum on the highest, the second or the third levels. Wherever it is perfect. supported bridge. Again, you can stay here. You can walk those feet out so that you're on your heels. Maybe draw those arms overhead in a T formation, opening up your lower back as much as possible, breathing in and out. Slowly inhale as you walk those feet back again. Draw your arms overhead. Exhale first. Then inhale as you push those hips up, release your block, and exhale inch by inch down again. Draw those knees in for a hug. Back and forth. And then cross that right leg over left, wrap your feet, eagle legs, arms out east and west, inhale first, exhale as they fall down to the left, look over your right shoulder, and breathe. Inhale back to center, unwrap, unwind, give yourselves a hug, and then cross that left leg over right, wrap your feet, arms around east and west, inhale first, exhale as those knees fall all the way to the right as far as you can, breathing in and out. Look over your left shoulder if this is in your practice. Inhale those knees back to center. Unwrap, unwind. Give yourselves a hug. Good job. And then from here, move into an inversion. So, actually, I don't need to touch. You can either take that block. Slowly inhale as you place it under your sacrum on the lowest level, and then just do legs straight up if that's in your practice, allowing the circulation to come back down to your brain and your vital organs. Or you can possibly do this without a block. Or you can follow us into a shoulder stand, walking those shoulders under as much as possible, feet are in Barbie feet. Breathing in and out, looking like a candlestick. Possibly draw those toes overhead in halasana or plow pose. Maybe grab onto your toes in upside down dandasana, opening up that lower back region even more. Possibly bend your knees, placing them around your ears in ear pressure pose or snail pose. And then inch by inch, vertebrae by vertebrae, coming back down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a hug. Inhale through your nose, side out, inhale. One more time, inhale. And with that intention, allow your legs to come out as wide as the mat or wider. Arms are out beside your torso, palms are up to receive down to ground, starting to relax. Relax your toes, relax your feet, relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your hips, relax your torsos, relax your fingers. Relax your hands, relax your wrists, relax your forearms. Relax your elbows, relax your upper arms, relax your shoulders. Relax your necks, relax your jaws, relax your cheeks. Relax your foreheads, relax the crowns of your heads. Just relax. Thank you. start to bring movement back to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Reach your arms overhead, extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch and filling your lungs with your breath. Then exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and kidneys once again. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Then using the strength of your arms, come back to a seated position. Facing the front of the room, legs are crossed. Hands are in Anjali Mudra. Heads are bowed in honor of our practices. From the place deep in my soul that I know to be pure and true, I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Monday. Have a wonderful rest of the day. Namaste. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Thank you all. I'm so glad you were here. And again, I'm so glad it's 2021 and we're going to beat coronavirus. Yay. And I hope everybody's doing well. And I will see you tomorrow.